is a very special show for me because I get to spend an hour with two friends, two sisters from a three-time Grammy-winning singing group. They've been at the top of the recording business for over two decades, which is it's hard to believe. Their latest recordings, Only Sisters Can Do That, and their song that is on the new Rhythm, Country, and Blues album are, I'm sure, going to just add new luster to an already amazing list of hits. Of course, I am talking about the Pointer Sisters. Before I bring them out, I would just like to say that me and the gals go back a ways together. I had the pleasure of working with the Pointers on the Carol Burnett Show. Let's take a little look at us as we were in the 70s.
Wow, that sure was an out-of-sight party last night.
Right on, honey.
Well, I didn't dig it so much. That new chick danced every dance with the prince, and I ended up having to dance with you.
And I had to cut in.
I wonder who that cool, witchy woman was.
Now, she sure wasn't from around here.
No way.
Cinderella, more hot water for the jacuzzi. Wait.
Well, of course, now you understand it was a bit of a stretch for me to play their mother because they're all a lot older than me. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like you to say hello to Anita and Ruth, the Pointer Sisters. Before we go one word further, we should explain that you have not been reduced to a duet.
No.
Well, no. June's not here because she's not well today.
Right.
Yeah, so she didn't make it. And whatever happened to Bonnie?
She's still here. She's still recording. She's working on some
but
records.
She left
she's
to do
writing
a solo
songs.
Career
she,
when? Well, it's been
1976. Yeah.
What did you think of that?
We hated
I
it.
I thought she was crazy.
I mean, were you mad?
We were very mad.
Mad is an understatement.
We were
furious. Really.
So confused. We didn't know what we were going to do, you know. So yeah. That's when we decided we would totally change our direction. We got out of the old clothes. And we got more became more contemporary, and it worked for us.
That was a good thing. Yeah.
It worked.
It really worked great for you. How hard is it being sisters? Because you're really hard pressed to find two sisters that get along great in this world.
Do you have any sisters?
Yeah, we don't even speak.
Oh no! Oh, no.
Is siblings working together constantly? Do you ever want to kill each other and?
Not quite kill each other.
You've never had knockdown dragouts through all the years. It's been a lot of years.
Oh no, not to that extent.
Bad.
But we have had our you know ins and outs.
When
and
we were very young, we fought a lot.
Oh yeah, she used to beat me to a pulp all the time.
What did
she
you fight
would
about?
Beat me up all the time.
Are you the
sharing?
She's the oldest. Yeah.
Sharing is a hard thing, you know, because younger sisters always want to get in your closet, wear your clothes, get in your stuff. I didn't want them in my stuff.
If you're the oldest, it's been my experience that the oldest one does not share.
No, the oldest does not share.
No.
Not really, not very well.
No, she never did. Well. She shared with her friends. I mean, her outside friends, but I wasn't considered one of her friends, so I was her sister.
That's right.
That's a very different thing.
Well, I guess that's what I'm saying. Sisters aren't friends. So is it hard work? Well, I mean, you guys are, but how hard is it working together for this many years?
I think it's easier because we're sisters, you know, because it's hard enough just doing what we do. And if we weren't in love with each other and if we weren't family, I don't think we would take some of the things that we take and bend and, you know, compromise the way we do.
Yeah.
I certainly don't think we would have been together 20 years.
No.
Yeah.
Thank you. Nobody sounds like sisters together either, or brothers.
Yeah, that's true.
So,
that's
nobody
true.
Sounds the same.
That's true.
It's so special.
Yeah.
You guys came from a very rigid upbringing.
Yes, very.
No music in the house or just...
Except gospel. On Sundays, we could hear gospel music.
And kind of country, too. You know, we listened to a little country music, I think, here and there.
One of the first records in the house was Elvis Presley's Crying in the Chapel.
Right.
Because there was a chapel in it?
Yeah.
Exactly. My mom, she, you know.
No, you so laugh.
It's
that's
okay.
Right.
Yeah. Because it says chapel.
Exactly.
Right.
That made it a little more gospel to my mom, I guess.
Ryan
and she
in
liked
the chapel,
that song.
At least he was in the chapel.
Right. He was in the church.
He was in the chapel, so it was all right.
So is that how come you girls just broke out and went nuts because you had this wicked upbringing?
Uh-huh. I really believe so. I really believe so.
Now, what, your dad was a... What was he, a minister, preacher?
Yeah,
preacher?
My mother, too.
He was the pastor of the church, and Mom was assistant pastor.
Now, are they still alive?
My mother is.
What does she think of you girls?
Oh, she's gotten over the shock, you know, that we decided to do this, so yeah. She's very happy about what we do.
Yeah.
Yeah, and she likes to come around, you know, and we dress her up, put makeup. She never wore
you
makeup before.
You make her into a pointer sister?
Oh, yeah. Do you mind? Yes, Lord.
She loves it.
She is the point of
mama.
Oh,
she's
God.
The point of mama.
Right.
So gospel was the first thing you really sang.
Yeah,
girls sang in church?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yep, we were in all the choirs from little
kids. Do you ever still do it just for fun?
Not in church. We haven't sung together in church in
many years,
and we should.
Yeah, but you're going to do a little gospel thing for us impromptu right now.
Oh, yeah, sure. Okay. We'll do a little song that was taught to us by the Watson sisters.
The Watson sisters, some of our best friends.
Yeah.
Because
were they sort of your inspiration, your mentors?
Our very first and
they
probably biggest
so
inspiration.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
As Jesus sat there on Mount Olive, disciples came to him privately saying, what shall be the sign of his coming and of the end of the world? Jesus said, take heed, let no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying that I am the truth, and I am the life, the truth, and living Christ. But don't you believe it? What shall be the sign of his coming? What shall be the sign of his coming? There's gonna be wars and rumors of wars. Earthquakes in diverse places, destruction and desolation. The moon dropped down in blood, the sun refused to shine. The glory of the Lord will then come down. This is a sign of his coming.
And next you're going to get some pointers on how to handle your man from the pointers. We'll be back. Sisters, I was just saying, you girls have gone through some wardrobe.
Oh, Lord.
We're in our conservative phase now.
Yes, we got church song today.
Thought it was...
Really?
Yes, daytime attire.
Now, what about men? Can we talk about men?
Oh, let's talk about
men. What have you learned over the years?
What have we learned?
Well, you've got to find a friend first. You really do. They have to be your friend before they can become your lover.
How hard is that when you're a woman in show business?
Oh, it's very hard.
Yeah.
It is. It's very hard because of the kind of lives we lead. We're from here to there, gone here one day and gone the next. And, you know, it's hard to keep relationship together.
Now, you're happily married.
I'm happily.
Are you married?
Happily at last.
Happy at last.
Happy at last, yes.
Married to?
Married to Mike Sales.
Yeah.
And he was a friend first. We met in the gym.
It's a good place to meet people.
Good place to meet, you know.
Nice
very little
place.
Clothes.
Right.
You know, you can see what's going
down
on
down
there.
The
yes, absolutely. You know, things are tight, you
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Chase, you can see what's going on.
See what's going on
there. Check out the assets.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So that was good. That was good.
But married for how long?
4 years this year. Yeah.
And brand new babies.
Brand new babies, twins.
Did you bring us pictures? You didn't bring us a picture of the babies?
Oh, you know. No.
Did you think she was nuts when she did the baby thing?
I sure did. I sure did.
They did. They thought I was crazy.
Because you've got grown children.
Yes.
Yes.
And grandchildren.
Ruth.
I'm reading this really great book, though, about men. It's called Knights in Rusty Armor.
What is this about?
It's all about this knight that always wanted to be ready for war, you know, and you know how men are. They always want to be ready for work, ready to go, ready, you know, and responsible or whatever. They just got to be ready for battle, you know, ready for a fight. So he wanted to be so ready that he refused to take off his knight suit, you know. So he got to the point where he wanted to sleep in it and eat dinner in it. So he wanted to be ready all the time. Well, his wife was getting pretty sick of this, you know, and she was like trying to feed him through the little cracks in the flap, you know. and the kid didn't even know what his dad looked like anymore because he was always in this damn suit.
Uh-huh.
So the suit starts to get rusty.
Oh, boy.
Well, he wants to get out of the suit now, you know, but he can't find any way to get out of it. And it's all about, you know, the moral is all about men that are always protecting themselves with the shell of, you know, I'm tough, you know, and then when it comes down to really wanting to change themselves and reveal who they really are, they have to go through some pain.
Because they're all rusty
and they got this thing on that they gotta take off.
That sounds kind of like a chastity belt or something.
It's a great, great book.
Yeah. What about men that I bet you've had to deal with some tough men in this business. I mean, just being a woman in, and I bet the recording industry is even worse than TV.
I don't know if it's worse.
I don't know if it's worse either.
I don't know, but you're dealing with men producers, you're dealing with men at the head of the record companies, and it's, you know, you're up against a brick wall many times when you're faced with that, you know?
Like what? What has been hard?
Getting your point across, being heard, getting your pointers across.
What have you guys had to fight about? Have you had to fight about material?
Sometimes.
Yeah. Wanting to change directions.
You know, egos really clash. Mm-hmm. You know, like if a guy is not in the same business, there's that edge where you start to wonder whether whose job is more important. You know.
Now you're talking about personal relationships.
Yeah. But I mean, like if they're not, you know, and even if they are, it's like, even if they are in the same business, it's like whose job is more important? I have to do this. I have to do that. Well, my thing has to come first, and no, my thing has to come first, sort of thing. You know, it's.
Now, we find it pretty easy though dealing with the musicians, the men, musicians that we work with. You know, they seem to have a different air about them. You know, they're not
as hard.
That's
because they're musicians, though.
Don't you? But
well,
you know,
musicians
when you're dealing
with producers,
are a totally different breed.
Yeah.
You know, when you go into the studio and they're in control, so to speak, you know, it's a whole different situation.
So now, are you looking for love in all the wrong places now?
No, I think I found it.
You have?
Yeah, I have. No, I have a wonderful relationship right now. I'm very, very happy.
Fabulous.
For a year.
Is it going to be?
It's been going on for a year, and I'm just taking it one day at a time.
A year is good.
Yeah.
A year is good.
You think you'll take the plunge again?
Well, maybe. No word on it yet, but maybe.
Think you might want to have twins?
No. we know the answer to that one.
I have
a granddaughter, and I'm very happy helping with her.
Girls, I can't even believe it.
I know.
Did you have babies when you were 12?
Yes.
Something like that.
I was close.
I was a teenage mother, but I'm very happy.
Now, is that the girl that I met today?
Yes, Jada.
She's so adorable.
And Roxy. Yeah.
Oh, gosh, you have to be so proud of her.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere, because next we're going to find out about the new man in the Pointer Sisters' life, and I'm talking about Clint Black, and you're going to see these ladies harmonize with somebody who has always wanted to be a Pointer Sister.
All right.
Can you guess who?
I love Vicki. Vicki. I love her. I love her. I love her.
I love Vicki.
Who's Vicki?
She's one hot babe.
Hey.
I love Vicki.
Vicki, I love you, babe.
We love Vicki.
I feel so loved.
I love Vicki.
You love her too.
Change, change, change.
Sisters, and this is kind of a fantasy of mine. What do you think here?
Yeah, huh? Yeah. Yeah. All right. All that's looking at our red hair.
Love it.
You, and you girls were responsible for picking out the wardrobe. I thought it was going to be outrageous, but we look so
nice.
Grown up.
Right.
We look like grown-up Pointer Sisters.
Grown-up look.
The song that we just saw the little clip of, the part, that's part of the video?
Yes, it's the video of the live recording in the studio.
Yeah. Now the album is called Country Rhythm and Blues.
Right.
It's an interesting album. It, for those of you who have not heard it, what they did was they paired up like one jazz artist with one country artist.
Right.
And redid a lot of old songs.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
What did you think of Clint Black?
Oh, he's a doll.
Fabulous.
And he's got this big old voice.
Yeah.
We had a really great time with him.
Yeah. Did you get to meet Lisa Hartman, too?
Oh, yeah, we knew Lisa already.
Oh.
We knew Lisa before she knew Clint.
So you got to dish old Clint.
We used to party with Lisa.
Oh, yeah. Really?
You know, just minor.
So, yeah, I know you girls never really partied hard.
Are you kidding?
Hey, you know, I don't think a lot of people are aware that you guys have country roots. You won a Grammy for a country song.
Yeah.
Our first Grammy.
Yeah.
What? And we wrote the song.
Yep.
And it was for which song?
Fairy Tale. And then we wrote another country song.
How did Fairy Tale go? Fairy Tale.
I pack up all my things and walk away. I don't want to hear another word you have to say.
All right.
I've been waiting for so long. Found out there's something wrong. Nothing
is it true?
Wait, you can't talk now. Oh,
is it true? Is it true? That you were the first black people. Were you the first black performers of the Grand Ole Opry?
The very first, yes. First black female group, that is.
Black female. So the curtain went up and everybody went, well, hot bam, them gals is black. Them gals is black. Was that, was it fun?
It was fun. Yeah. It was fun. Yeah.
We were so nervous, but they treated us so nice.
Ooh, what a good time.
Were you babies? Grand Ole Opry was when?
This was 74?
Yeah, we were babies. 74?
Something like that.
Yeah.
10, 11, something like that.
This is what we're going to do now is sort of like a fantasy of mine. And I think that since June couldn't be here, I just sort of kind of stepped in and took over.
Hey.
Good girl.
All right.
Good girl.
And then Clint's not here, so you really needed somebody.
We really needed it, I'm telling you.
Yeah. So I'm here to help.
All right. I know you can handle it.
Help me, girl.
So let's do Chain of Fools.
All right. Let's do it.
Late in the day. My doctor said, take it easy. Overture loving is much too strong. I'm at it too. Your chain, chain, chain. Chain, chain, chain.
Bad for your digestive system. Your comments, suggestions, and show ideas are all welcome. Just call 1-900-28-VICKY. That's 1-900-288-4254. Call costs 75 cents and you must be at least 18 to call. Special guests today are Anita and Ruth Pointer, and right now, since the girls are here, I thought it would be fun if they helped me answer some of my viewer letters.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, well, we get lots of mail around here, and it's always fun to hear what people have to say. Mm-hmm. First letter is from M.B. Wright of Fort Worth, Texas, who wrote, "To whom it may concern, I'm addressing this to all of those people in your organization who do not realize that you are working on color TV.
Oh, please.
All your viewers get is black, 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 and more black.
Yes, yes, black is beautiful.
That's what we like, right?
don't turn it into a rally now, girls. Actually, I believe that the... the writer is actually referring to the wardrobe, I think. It goes...
Oh,
yeah. Excuse me.
It goes on to... I picked a good day for this one, didn't I?
Really. Look,
everything around here is black. It says black suits, black dresses, black pantsuits, black sweaters, black shirts, black blouses. We viewers bought color sets to enjoy color.
Oh, my God. You say this is from M.B. Wright. Now, do we know this person's sex?
Just that they're not getting enough.
Yeah,
why would he be complaining?
We don't know if it's a he, she, miss, or whatever, but obviously MB does not understand that black happens to be a girl's best friend.
That's right. I mean, black.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
I mean, black covers up any flaws you might have. Not that we have any.
Right.
True.
Except maybe Vicki. I'm just kidding, girl.
Thanks, Anita. We also heard from Chet Larson in Solana Beach, California, who writes, "Dear Vicki Lawrence, you and your show are good for what ails our country. You deserve to be in prime time," it says.
That's true. Yeah. I agree.
It says, "Today during your Stress Buster show, I laughed so hard, I peed in my pants."
I see it.
I see it.
Peed in my pants.
That's actually there. They
Chet,
actually
yes,
that.
It is. When they came up with interactive TV, I don't think that's exactly what they had in mind.
But thanks for sharing.
Yeah. Oh, Lord.
What Chet doesn't mention here is that he also pees during Good Morning America, the evening news, and the entire primetime lineup.
Oh, my God. Well, look, for your honesty, Chet, why don't we? I think he deserves some kind of credit, right?
And some of these.
Yeah.
think these are perfect for Chet.
Yes,
made just for him.
And by the way, I was just kidding about Chet peeing during all the shows. He never pees during Good Morning America. All right, you guys, that brings me to my last letter. It is from Norma Chambers, who was just kind of ticked off in general. Norma was very upset about a number of things. Among other things, she writes, "Stop calling everyone you guys." Oops, I just did that, didn't I? And Norma also says, "Stop saying pee when you're referring to a bodily function."
Oh, please.
I don't know.
What did she say? Urinate?
I don't know, but I think, Norma, that we'll probably forward your letter along to Chet, because he's the one that started it all, right, girl?
Right. Yeah, send it to him.
On the other hand, Norma may have something there, you know.
You go do Norma's show next time, then, Ruth. Chet, actually, for being such a wonderful good sport, I'm going to send you one of my fabulous Vicki t-shirts.
I love it.
I also have another one for you, Norma, but you were so mad at us, you didn't even bother to send us your address. I have a special shirt for MB.
Yes,
MB.
MB's favorite color.
We don't know it's a he. Why do we keep saying he?
Whatever.
It could be a she. And how tall and thin is she that black is not her best friend?
For real.
Thanks. Thanks for writing to all of you, and thanks, gals, for helping me out.
Sure.
We love hearing from all of you. Honestly, we do. Write us, please, at Vicki, 3000 West Alameda Avenue, room 1904, Burbank, California, 91523. Don't go anywhere, because next we're going to learn of when these ladies are going to take a walk. A walk of fame, that is.
I love Vicki.
Vicki, I love you, babe.
We love Vicki.
I feel so loved.
I love Vicki.
Sisters, now tell us what's going on. You have you're all scheduled to get the star on the Walk of Fame in Hollywood.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're supposed to be in January, and
then the earthquake came and upstaged us.
Earthquake
on the day you were supposed to do it.
Not on the day. But
3 days before.
Like 3 days before.
Oh, yeah. Bummer.
Yeah.
So now what's going on?
We're
going
to do it in September. It'll either be the
22nd or the 25th, I hear.
So just come out the 22nd and
hang out. Bring your sleeping bags. Where's it going to be? Do you know?
Yes, Hollywood and Cahuenga.
Who are you in between?
I don't know that. I don't know.
Oh, you haven't gone to check it out yet.
I
can't get a star. I don't know who you have to.
You can come with us.
Start with you.
I'm an honorary Pointer Sister now, aren't I?
Sure, come out there. Now we're gonna put Vicki in there down there.
Ruth and Anita, June and Vicki. Now tell me about what is this about you guys doing voodoo when you were first starting to make it? Because you could get in trouble doing that.
Yeah, that's what I know. But you know what? It worked for us. We used to do little what do you call them?
Ceremonies.
And we'd have this powder stuff.
What, you make potions and stuff?
We'd go to, what's the place? The Magic Eye.
Yeah.
And we'd buy these powders, and we'd burn them, and we'd say little things that we wanted to happen.
Yeah. To people. It was. They did. To people that made them mad.
But we said we wanted the Trans World Building, which we call the Pointer Building in San Francisco. We said that'll be finished in 73, and our album will be out in 73. And it happened.
That's true, it did.
You know, it really works good.
You don't do that stuff anymore, do you?
No.
We used to scare our manager to death. We'd call him up in the middle of the night and tell him the evil spirits are gone and just he can go on with his work now.
I'm telling you, you get in trouble doing that stuff.
I know.
I really do believe that it works, though.
Now,
how
many kids do you have?
I have one daughter.
And you have grown, now I'm talking about grown kids.
Three.
Well, two grown ones, one 16-year-old.
Well, that's, you know.
That's grown.
Huh? Well, it's scary is what it is.
Scary grown.
Do they want any aspirations to follow you guys into the business?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. My 16-year-old has a fantastic voice.
What can you do to... Is there anything you can do to help them?
Well, we do everything we can. They see what we've been through, and they see how hard it is.
for
it's
us.
It's really hard.
And it's worse now. I mean, there's so much more to compete with out there now than it was when we started. So
there's so much more to learn, too. You know, it's like we had nobody to really tell us about the business end of the business. And we at least have that much knowledge that we can tell our kids about certain things. You know, we didn't know about paying agents and paying lawyers and bookings. And, it's so much. It's so much to know.
Has that been a hard lesson?
So at times it has been.
Yeah, because you know what I think? People always say to me, how do you get into show business? And I always say, I think you should major in business.
Yeah, yeah.
Minor in abnormal psychology. I'm serious.
That's the truth.
So then at least you could hold on to the money when you make it.
That's true.
And maybe you could figure out the people that are running this business.
Yes, it's hard.
I'm serious.
That's right.
I'm dead serious. I get to be June again, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited. What are we going to do now?
Slow.
Let's do it. Yeah. Oh, that's a different song, isn't it? We didn't get to that one yet. Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
I'm going to sing in the key of Ruth.
All right.
All right.
Okay.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, let's hit it, boys.
For only $24.95, just call Video Archives at 1-800-4-VIDEO.
very special guest today, the Pointer Sisters. Who's got? You know, I got a quick question for you. How much are you guys touring? A lot?
A lot. Yeah, a lot.
How physical is the show? How long is the show?
About an hour and 20 minutes.
Hour 20.
Is it real physical still?
Pretty physical. Yeah. We get real excited once we get up there. And yeah, still jumping.
That probably keeps you in pretty good shape then, yeah?
Pretty good shape.
Yeah. And who? I was going to ask, too, who's this little thing down here? Is this one of yours?
That's my granddaughter, Roxy.
Roxy's bored. I don't think she's enjoying
it. I think she fainted from excitement.
But she is probably the cutest.
She's heard that song before.
She's a little pointette, we decided.
Yes, she is.
Did you have a question? Stand up.
Hi. I was wondering if you were always singing in your home together, because I have two other sisters and we were always singing.
Yes. Mm-hmm. We used to sing all the commercials on TV.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything. Every
Did you
song.
Know that you were going to do that? Is this what you thought you were going to be when you grew up?
No.
What did you think you were going to be?
Secretary or something like that.
That's... Oh, hi. Anita. No, I can't see it. Question?
Yes. I just want to know if you have a fan club, because I'm a big fan of yours.
Yes, we do.
Yes.
And the lady sitting right in front of you. And my daughter, Jada.
Here? No.
The
here,
one
where?
Holding the...
President of the fan club?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well,
she can give you all the information you need.
How big is fan club?
It's growing daily, and it's wonderful. And everybody, if you want to join, just talk to us after the show. It's great.
What's your name?
Gina.
What's the biggest dish on the Pointer Sisters, Gina?
Ah!
Something we don't know about them that we should. Inquiring minds want to know.
I can say on the air.
Yeah, okay, that you can say on the air.
Oh, you know what? Everything about them is true. There's nothing dishy. They're the greatest, warmest, sweetest human beings I know.
Yeah.
Oh,
thank you.
They are.
Gina.
I have to agree with that. What's your question?
I just wanted to ask, which one of you guys lead sing the most?
Is there a most lead singer?
There's not a most in this group.
No, we don't allow that.
We split it up evenly.
Do you fight over certain songs?
Sometimes. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What song did you fight
over? Silent fight, like, I want to lead that song, and if you don't let me lead it, I'm going to have a fit.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What do you do?
Stand up.
I was wondering if you ever thought that voodoo would come back to haunt you.
That who would come back to haunt us?
If voodoo will come back to haunt them?
Oh, no, it's going to work with us. It's going to help us.
Yeah, it's going to...
It's working right with us.
You can tell them they can get in trouble doing that stuff. You know, it's like Ouija boards.
This
don't touch them.
This was good voodoo.
Give me that back.
Hi, I just wanted to know if what are some of the major changes that you guys have seen in the music industry from when you started until now?
Major changes?
Some of the major changes.
Electronics.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely.
You used to go in the studio and you'd have musicians there, and, you know, everyone would beat the strings, the horns, the rhythm section, and now you go in and there's the engineer and the producer and the machine.
How about the business side of it?
It's much more a big business than it was in the past.
More about business than it is about music.
Yeah.
Yeah. Vicious, I would imagine.
Vicious.
That's sad.
Wow, I say. Girls, will you do, this is one of my favorite songs, and I don't know how any of you can stay seated. Would you do the Neutron Dance?
If you can. You know we will.
Thank you.
For tickets to Vicki, please send a self-addressed stamped envelope to NBC Tickets, Vicki, 3000 West Alameda Avenue, Burbank, California, 91523. The Pointer Sisters, Anita and Ruth, for making this such a fun show for all of us.
Hey, guys. They're always so much fun.
Thank you.
And, June, hon, we missed you, and I hope you get to feeling better really, really soon.
How about our power trio here?
Yeah, introduce the power trio.
Gilbert. This is Jan.